In terms of the atmosphere of the moment, you know what I mean, and what it carries with it, you know what I mean. Because again, over here, it's easy to read because we're sitting on top of the largest vortex in the northern hemisphere. So all I do is look at the people, how they acted, how they go and come, and the names, you know what I mean. Like for instance, my sister named Diamond. Just come on, man, looking good too. And Diamond's a good man, showing up in the rub, but at the same time, just a diamond show she is. And what I mean is, things like this let me know. Like, okay, Diamond just come home last night. Well, I knew it was just a little while before the diamond slowed down out to heaven. What do I mean by that? Well, after every hardship, there's ease. And nobody said none of this shit would be easy. But we did say it would be rewarding. And so is. And everybody has to know it, you know. Look at the fabric of your own existence. How you do what you do, you know, who you talk to in your day-to-day lives, the things you choose to say, the things you find yourself listening to. These things play a part. All, put in position and blasted right there on the canvas of the bigger picture. You see what I mean?
Ooh.
And now, I've asked that everybody be present. Now, I'm going to give these niggas, listen, a little more opportunity. Now, I'm going to give them about 5 or 10 more minutes. You just keep on calling the niggas, Tell them niggas I say get there, not now, right now. If they don't, then they're the same on it. You see what I mean? And we'll just do it another time. You see?
Right.
But you got, when you're old, you know, you're dealing with elders, you got to move at that elder's pace. You can't move with your own. They ain't going to happen.
Right.
That ain't going to happen. I want y'all to know I'm older than all y'all. I'm 73 trillion years old. Shit.
Mm-hmm.
Right, but I want to mess with them numbers, y'all. Come on, let me tap dance with you. You know, see if you want to get.
Ain't nobody trying to mess with them numbers, G. Ain't nobody
touch
them.
Them numbers are phenomenal. They gag you. That's right. And it's good to hear all our family come together, man. Let me tell you. And now, 2 weeks from now, like I say, I'm coming in now. I want all the Esoites to gather and this be the first. Where all us niggas and Negroes, you know, come together and put in the same place, same time in the physical. That's going to be the day now, man. We're going to film it. We're going to eat. We're going to out teach. You know what I mean? We're going to do a whole lot of things. We're going to walk and talk and film the people that we talk to in the street. Hey, it's going to be something to look at, man. You know what I mean? So, I want you to find me a sister to make me a decent guard for that day. That's the day that you go walking with that Tomb Raider in Atlanta. We're going to film that, put it out on YouTube. You hear me?
We're going to be in Atlanta?
Yeah, we're here. We're doing Atlanta.
Is that going to be 2 weeks from now or a week from now?
Yeah, 2 weeks. No, 2 weeks from now, I expect to have had a ticket at the airport. I don't get on the plane, but you know what I mean. You might drink a little small shot of Hennessy. I don't like
it. I know. I'm trying to make sure I can take off. I got to take off some time at work, and I want to put it in now, and I want to make sure, you know, that that's it, so that I can take that time off and drive down there.
Yeah. Man, I want everybody there for the greet me. What I mean by that, you're going to film that too. Shit. Document the whole endeavor. You see what I mean? That's right. And then we'll go from Atlanta and, you know, go over to Houston and Dallas. You know what I mean? Maybe, I don't know, maybe go up north. I don't know. But I know before long I'm going to have to go to Bushwick Avenue and deal with Polite and their bullshit. You know, turn the cells over and act fool. A little something, you know.
Yeah.
He's still up to his mess. Well,
he's about to,
you see, they ain't playing with him now, you know. If I'm not mistaken, don't he got a charge or something like that?
They're putting together a lawsuit
going out. What is he up against? What is it?
Oh, Fizz.
Huh?
Racketeering, no.
Racketeering? No, ain't that
stuff. Taking people money.
Yeah, they
thousands, too.
I don't understand how they call what he's doing like a, what exactly is he doing? They can charge him with racketeering. I don't know. What is it? I'm saying, what's he doing? Like he's collecting donations. What is he doing?
All right, so he's taking donations. Scamming, taking donations, and, you know, for thousands of dollars, and not, you know, following through with the work he says he's going to do.
Yeah, well, selling products, people not getting their products.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Let me say something to you. You know, I don't understand how in the world they think for 1 minute that they can take Baba's holy tablets, sell them on the net for $6.50, do all that other shit that you just told me, and expect not to get no shit. You know what I mean? Shit stinks. And they don't bring them but some toilet paper and a toilet bowl. You understand what I mean? True, you know, that's the day that the like Baba said, that's the day like the TP. He said, teleport him. That TP stands for toilet paper, too. and he told him the story about the rabbit and the bear. And he said, the bear picked the rabbit up and said, you're brown now.
And wiped his butt with him.
Right, if he says, tell PP, if you keep talking bad about my son, I'm going to wipe my ass with him. That's what Baba said. We laughed like a motherfucker. Yeah, we did. I remember that day. That's what Baba said. Man, that's something. We ain't heard from good old TP no more. Not doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And see, now, What I do know is when motherfuckers have a way of doing things that ain't cool, you think for 1 minute, let's look at girl Sarah. Bible say I'm administering to her entire globe as we speak. You understand the gravity of that statement?
Mm-hmm.
Think about that. Think about that. And sure enough, you see the results showing up, didn't you, man? Everything I'm saying is coming to pass just like I said it. Now, let me tell y'all something. It's a little more now. Once the Osirites come together, the devil going to go smooth crazy. The wind going to blow hard that day. You know why? But, man, let me tell y'all something. Six-point star, the hyperbola, all these things will be pushed into motion to lock that stuff down to get us, you know, get us all in one place safe. Yeah, let me tell you, I'm a drawing the blackboard. You might even, Bobby and Truth, you might even do their thing right up in the sky, but you all can bear witness to it. How that's 5-point star, that's 6-point star works and traps loop. You see what I'm saying? Because you can't kill the devil, you can only trap his ass. Make him stand down so we can get some things what done. And see, he mad as a motherfucker. He wanna know how he mad? You know, because he know it's been Luke knows. Anybody going to know how you know he knows? But look at all the blockage we came up against in the last week or so. I'm talking superior blockage. I'm talking this nigga has practically broken himself up and centralized extremely, you see. And Luke doing his thug thing, you might know. Because you're trying to slow us all down. Now you can't stop us, Luke, but you can slow it down. You know, we know, but we know what you do. And let me tell you something, Luke. You better stop that shit. You better stop. And that's what I told him before. Man, let me tell you, we locked him up. I was in ad shag in county jail one time. And I set up this shrine, you know what I mean? The shrine come alive in back there. See, you know, but I go to ad shag so I can do some things and can't nobody see them, you know. I don't like being in general population. And that's the only place you can talk shit to the police. Like, I see the police feeds you food, so I be telling them, set my food down over there and get out of here, slave. And, you know what I'm saying? I was calling them slaves. You know what I'm saying? Get your ass out of here, slave. You know what I mean? And then yeah, but that's the only place the police feed you the food when you're on the ass. Everybody else be rooms. I mean, inmates. So, you know, they the ones feeding the food. The police overlook it. But when you're on ass, the police bring you your tray. So I say, yeah, put my food down over there and get the hell out of here, slave. Make sure you close the door, too. Mm-hmm. And every time they lock my ass, you know, when they lock me up, the first thing I yell out the door, don't forget, you got to feed me. They don't like that part.
Right.
Now. Yeah, I get somewhere and sat down. Motherfucker, then it started spitting in my tray. I caught the motherfucker spitting in my tray, so I start fasting. Tray's building up like a motherfucker. I done fasted 30 days in this motherfucker. They sent me lieutenant, the captain down there. What's wrong, Brady? Why are you not eating? Because the motherfucker spitting in my tray over there. I said, yeah, the fool right there, don't hide behind your co-worker. He the main one. He put all the police together. And, yeah, him. Yeah, I been pointing them all out. Yeah. Next thing you know, heads rolled. Meaning they changed everything that was around my ass. And then he asked me, do you want to go back in general population? What the hell for? A TV? For me to smell another nigga shit in the cell with me? Nah, I'd rather stay right here. I'm just fine. You can't stop me from reading books, you know. And you can't stop me from building this rhyme. But I was so upset. What the hell he doing? When he got this shit all up against the wall and orange peelings and all types of that. Man, because you have to have something smell good. So I take the orange peelers, throw them over there, you know. Give me some leaves off the ground when I go out in the yard.
Yeah.
Crush them up, put them up.
That's a natural air freshener.
Natural air freshener, man.
They kill odor, too. If it's smelling
absorb
anything,
it.
Them orange peelings will absorb it. You
absorb
the right
it. That's
sure.
Man, I had them going on. And see, let me tell you now what you do. Like, I got a picture. I got to get Life magazine, man. I look at all these pictures. I got a picture of a Nubian dog, Nubian, you know, priest, you know, high priest, you know. Set it up there and then set one over this side and put food in front of the deity. Keep feeding the deity. Oh, man, that thing's coming alive. Yeah. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Motherfucker, the altar. Motherfucker, that altered the state. Saeed. I noticed I didn't call him Ali no more. Little Saeed. He's going to get a chance to get right. Yeah, you get a kind of get right or you get a kind of get wrong. Yeah, no more of that bullshit coming around here with that bullshit talking about set up altar. First of all, who gave you clearance? So, you want to have an altered state, all right? You got to alter the state right into something different, and you won't ever be able to fix it. You in the good, wanting to fuck with something, don't know what you're fucking with yourself. Better be careful when you get the opening up of dimensions and doing this high-powered extraterrestrial shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you better do. You know, like I know. But, man, you mess with something, you don't know how to turn it off. And so let's let you sit there wallowing in your stupidity because you hadn't been fucking with it in the first place. Why? Because you didn't have clearance. You know? Oh, fucker, you just don't trot your little ass over to another dimension like you somebody. Like you call inside this shit, man, yeah, see the movie, your own universe, like what you can't breathe. You know, I told you about the sister sitting at the dinner table named Monica Williams. Monica Williams was running her mouth. So motherfucker, she had a machine gun mouth. She talked faster, my brother, and I'm gonna tell you, I was sure whether her brain can move as fast as her mouth, you know. And I don't think Baba was feeling the same way. So, cause Baba said, reach over and touch her. So I reached over and touched her. Bow. Let me tell you something. That woman took her entire voice away. Where she was moving lips and nothing coming out. So it's stressing out me to where it became, man, painful to her. She's trying to talk and there ain't nothing coming out. She don't hear nothing, right? And to the point she just started crying and laid her head down on the table, crying now, because she know that I had touched it and took her, you know, me and Bobby touched her on the hand and took her voice away. Then Bobby said, now touch her again. And she, I touched her, she sat up, and then her voice came back. And, yeah, she cried real tears because she was talking too fucking much.
Having
absolutely nothing. Scared the fuck out of her, man. She moved, lip just the moving, right? Monica Williams. You know Monica Williams? You know Monica Williams? You got a brother named Tony Williams? Yeah. Uh-huh. Scared the fuck out of her up in Jackson Mountain. And I seen Lakeisha. You know, I had on the phone. I had Lakeisha L. Lewis on the phone with me. You know who that is? LLL, Lakeisha L. Lewis, that's ISIS. So, yeah, the real deal, Holyfield, on the phone with me the other day. Yeah, I did. Mm. Yeah, she come in, come down here with a homosexual sitting right next to her in the car. Mm-hmm. Yes, she did. You look good. Now, you have to keep in mind, her grandmother's name in this life is Nana. My grandmother's name in this life was what? Was Hermine. In this life, my grandmother's name on my mother's side is named Hermine. Her grandmother's name is Nana. So, again, what you have is Tahuti had personified in a feminine form to see to it that certain virtues be instilled in me at a young age. So, you know, Tahuti, my grandfather, from 24,000 years ago, personified in human form as my grandmother here today, in this life. And because how many people you know named Hermine? You ever heard that name before?
Mm-hmm.
I never heard no woman named Hermine ever before. Mm-hmm. My grandmother's name was Hermine Mays. You ever heard a name like that in your life?
Mm-hmm. Nope.
Which ties into the name Hermes. You follow me?
Yep.
And when you talk about Hermes, now you're talking about the first hermit amongst us, who was Tahuti. Now, what is a hermit?
You talking about like a hermit? Hermit is something that stays hidden or stays inside something?
Yeah, secluded. Secluded away from everything, everybody. Tahuti got away from fool ass niggas. Those niggas are talking too much of shit. They thought he was crazy, but he wasn't crazy. He was just smarter than them. You see what I'm saying? So what he do? Mm-hmm. He just moved his stuff away so he can pay full attention to the science itself and what it was, you know, what was being displayed, you know. And the cave, believe it or not, in the caves of the Himalayas, you know, where Mount Fuji is here today, where the Tibetan monks are up there still doing their thing. You feel me? at Tahuti's Hall. You know, that home style is still going out. And now when you see the Golden Child with Eddie Murphy, like, can I get the knife, please? Well, that's me.
That was one of my favorite movies, too.
Can I get the knife?
I used to love that movie, man.
That's what. Yeah.
See,
you see, like,
please,
yeah. You know, that's what I'm talking about. See, when you see the little Golden Child, they had him surrounded by evil. So I was like, this is what the hell you can have surrounded by all the time. Surrounded by them, surrounded by that man, every dirty bird you can think of. But let me tell you something, do you really think for 1 minute? If you're doing something that's going to stomp the devil's system out to the point that we all have new and beautiful lives called heaven right here on the blue rock, if this devil ain't going to do, you put up everything he's got to stop that from happening, you motherfuckers better think again. This motherfucker going to fight. And y'all going to bear witness as we do battle with this beast. And all that, man, we got weapons you can't even put now. We got weapons you can't, I don't even know if they got names, some of them. Ain't that something to have a weapon you can't, don't even have a name? You just pick that shit up and just, yeah, you know what I mean? Just right. Like, pick that thing up, that thing over there, you know what I mean? It's the one thing, you ain't the one that only got no name. You know what I mean? What you already know, you already know. Do it now, that's right. It's right out of the mouth. And see, that's why I say, everybody need to be talking about something that makes sense. Everybody need to be talking about something that pertains to what we're doing. You give it life, you know, through the virtue of, listen, thought first. Because keep in mind, Tuesday's name was also Thoth, the Atlantean. When you say Thoth, the Atlantean, all you're saying is Thoth, the Atlantean. Because these was his what? Thoughts. You follow me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, and when you read, any of y'all ever read the Immortality, you get that humming noise out. What the hell is that?
Hold on.
What the fuck is right there? The phone go crazy. I can do it back to the air.
My bad, Chief. I'm driving in the truck. I'm sorry.
No, listen. It's all right. I'm directing that too, love one. I'm directing all them alphabet boys, you know, giving a good listen right now, you know. They ain't on. I done converted a whole bunch of them. They done quit the job. I'm telling you, man. Motherfuckers say, you want me to tap the Messiah's phone? Are you crazy? I'm not tapping Jesus' phone. Fuck that. I quit. Yeah, that's real. That's ready. That's real. But, you know, and Grandpa, you know what he do? Is he'll shine, let him shining through in certain times and places. How? Because all of a sudden the imagery will start to, you know, develop and form. Right there before you know it. And in a reflective situation, it could be a vase, you know, holding flowers in a corner. You look over and all of a sudden there it is, all the imagery telling you the story. And see, that's how real, listen, I say, masons do what they do. They set their environments up in a way by which the alchemy is set up right there in front of you, but you don't see it to be. So you don't see it because it looks all natural. And a big fat cracker sit up in the corner and eating on crackers and shit, or eating on whatever you're eating on, watching TV. And he's got monitors everywhere in his living room. But he's able to just turn his head and look and see these people doing this thing on Mars and that, the motherfuckers doing that over there, blah, blah, blah. All seeing our shit in the mood, you see. See, but the thing is, they're able to do what they do because they place centurions, right? These are motherfuckers who sit in one spot and don't motherfucking move. You tell one nigga, well, sit there and don't motherfucking move, you know, please. You have a hard time with some shit like that, no, won't you? But niggas gotta learn how to sit their asses up still when they talk. You know, like I know, because you have to have one anchor to anchor the equation. What do I mean by that? Well, you have to have one motherfucker who is weighs heavier than everybody else to sit on one side of the room. And that nigga don't move because he's the biggest amongst us. And so he anchors the shit because other than that, the whole room will tilt, literally. If you got too much furniture on one side of the room and too little furniture, and you got this big fat motherfucker on this side of the room, what side of the room? You know that damn room going to tilt, whoop, and that side going to go up. Holy crazy, fucked up now, off balance. Yeah, imagine you got to juggle through that shit. But me and Bodie, check this out, was running up a hill. But when that wheel was first being introduced to us, and the hill kept getting steeper and steeper and steeper and steeper, and the bags kept getting heavier and heavier. And then don't y'all notice how you put some tennis shoes on, they're feeling good, and all of a sudden one tennis shoe get tighter than the other one? And it's hurt, you know, you heard the one foot hurting like a motherfucker. You say, damn, why this shoe fit good and this one don't? Now, no, both of them are the same size, but you got to understand. Listen, the magnetic pull is causing certain things to expand and contract in your universe, and you don't notice it. You notice it when your feet start hurting, one foot hurting like a motherfucker, and you say, damn, look at why this, but this shoe biting like a fuck, but this shoe feel good. I used to fuck them up. I just get one shoe. I get two pair of shoes. One size, I wear size 8. I get two pair. One size 8 and one size 9. And when one shoe start hurting, I take that one off, put the size 9 on. Fuck them up with that. People who have one size 8 on, but they be the same shoe. And yeah, that's who on the line talking here, man? Who on? Ain't nobody on here?
Hey, it's still Anthony and Tank. I don't know if somebody else might have got on the line. I mean that. Hey, Shay, Big Sis, how you doing?
Hey, just finding yourself.
Hey, I mean that. You on the phone?
Yes, I am.
Hey,
I just got a text message.
Finding you. There you go. What's going on? I'm doing a lot. Miss you, girl.
Nice to hear your voice again.
Good
in a while.
Man, shoot, I was over here doing battle. Man, I'm over here doing battle with a beast. I had to tie his ass up, you know. Shut him down for a little while. I had to get on the phone. You see, I couldn't even get on the phone. Motherfucker stole my phone. You know, getting that man blocking every damn thing with all his jujitsu moves and into the dragon. And here came the motherfucker, smoke coming out of his mouth and everything. I mean, I lived up, man. Went through hell with gasoline drawers on. Check this out. Ring the fire with gasoline drawers on and survive, baby. Here I am. Yeah, I am. When I say that, I mean what I say. Y'all just don't know. Y'all just don't have the slightest clue. All the moves this damn fool went through just to keep me from getting on the phone with y'all. That's why when I got the phone back, the first thing I told Brandon, when I called, what I tell you, Brandon?
You told me, are you ready to talk to everybody?
I said, yeah, get everybody on the phone. What? Not like what?
Now.
I can have a chance to ask whatever they want. I know it's been some days, but I want y'all to know I don't never stay with my family like that unless, check this out, I'm being attacked. I'm dealing with some things that I got to. I just can't. You can't, you know, sometimes fight this fool and talk on the phone at the same time. It's just a hard thing to do. Especially when you got all types of elements coming in your face from the left of you, the right of you, in front of you, above you, and under you. I mean, that's how I'll be sometimes. It ain't that I don't love y'all. I want you to know I love you with all of me. And I'm coming. Yeah, but they told you I'm coming to the East Coast. I'm coming to the East Coast in 2 weeks. Walk away. The show will be called Walk Away Afton Way in Atlanta. And I want all the Osirites there. Osirites. Right? That's right. I'm going to show you how to salute. I'll salute the military thing. You got to get some artists. I want some artists there. You know what I'm saying? I want some artists there. See, because we're going to design our ceremonial, which is our and our day-to-day job and our military job. And then I have to also create a flag. A flag where these are things that still have to be done. And I'm going to delegate certain responsibilities out to each and every one. Now, what I'd like you to do, if you don't mind, I would like you to help Tank with his side, meaning sometimes the phone calls are too much for the brother to handle. I mean, I could tell because you'd be bone tired, boss. Bone tired.
I always ask, you know, what can I do? Don't I, Tank?
Yeah, well, I'm saying, well, I mean, I heard you. I went to, what can you do? What I'm saying is, I want you to start something up where you answer the phones too. Meaning, we're going to have not just one Osirites office, we're going to have two and two different locations. You follow me? The work that you see Tank do, you duplicate in, where are you, Virginia?
Yes.
Okay, you duplicate that same work in Virginia. Meaning we'll have an Osirites office in Atlanta and also an Osirites office in Virginia.
Ooh.
You'll be in charge of the Osirites office in Virginia. You follow me?
Yes.
Now, what that means is you're going to have to set up several lines by which, you know, a communicative link is available to all our people at on a 24-hour time period. You have to set up lines where you'll be talking to people on behalf of, you know, our cause, whatever it may be. And then I'm thinking, like, I might even want to see what to find a location where we can put several lines, you know, phones, where we do a telepath, you know, how they drum up funding, telecommunication, you know, where we ask people for funds and should have certain safety to the world move, a telemarketing situation. You follow?
Okay.
Telemarketing.
Yes.
The Save the Children World Movement's cause. And you see, when you have our people calling Toys R Us, all the different Pampers, you understand what I mean? I want all them crackers on the line, and, you know, ask them for every dime that they should be giving to us. You see?
Okay.
You see?
Yep.
See, if they don't, like, you don't want to give any money to Save the Children World Movement, then what we'll do is we'll boycott their asses, and these two people, you know, get money off the children, of the world, and they don't want to give anything back to children that may be suffering. You follow?
Okay, I'm just interested to know how do I, because it's been on my mind for months. How do I actually start the Children's World Movement? What's the first step?
This is what you do. First step is I want you to find a T-shirt store that makes T-shirts, okay? Then I want you to take and put our logo on 12 T-shirts, okay? And then I want you to get you one of the machines that make little laminated IDs or whatever have you. Because you have to have your laminated out your card, you know, it's your little name, your little picture, but, you know, you understand what I mean. And then we'll solicit, you know, volunteers in that area to come and assist you. And see, and you'll be in charge. Now, what I mean, the first step is to get the T-shirts, set them to the side. Now, they ain't going to happen overnight. It's like a pregnant woman and a farmer. Remember those, I told you that. And then nothing changes. Everything happens over the course of time. First, it happens in the mind, honey. You think about it, it's right there, you know, laying on your couch, all that thing. You see it in your mind's eye, right? Well, then what do you do? Right? You sit there and visualize it. You see it. Visualization before what? Manifestation. You follow me? So you got to sit back and look at it and see it in your mind, God, and then you're sitting there, Lord have mercy, this here look good, this is what we're going to do. I can see it clearly. And when you get the picture in your head, then you get up. Now, what I mean by that, now you get it, a little water, a little sunshine. Well, the water, you know what I mean by that, it's moving, it's like a river now, you know, and that's what moves you to get your ass up off the couch. Because water of the experience is now being given to you. You see, so that moves you, right? So now you're going search up. You're going search of the materials that you need, you see, to make what you're seeing in the vision a physical reality. That's when the root of the seed is that sprouted out, and now the little motherfucker pushing his head through the soil, you know. And then you give it a little sunshine. What I mean by that, you keep thinking with a smile on it, you know. Mercy can. Keep thinking with a smile on it, if you get my drift.
Okay.
That's the sunshine right there. Guaranteed the little motherfucker going to grow after a while. Same way you seen us grow. We run that man, one or two. We teleport, we do what we do. And then birdie, you know, and then back and forth. And then we had good old Methatune. He was able to call himself the most low God. I said, Lord, everybody, he's a damn fool. You didn't crack self, smoke yourself. But my mother got in there, he asked me, yo, where can I get some crack? I said, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You hear what I say? And then when I went to Tennessee, they got a boy come to me. The buddy boy to meet me getting off Greyhound. The boy meet me, guess what his name was? Fuma.
Wow.
You know what the word Fuma means in Spanish? I said, his name was Fuma, and he was skinny as well, looking like a 24-carat crackhead himself. I just a bowler, and he had the high beams on. I said, Lord, who is this kid? Come to meet me. Right? And he's been making money hand over foot, making this, and selling what? T-shirts. Now, you know, come back around and start, you know. At that part, you know, the next thing you know, I'm doing radio show, and these motherfuckers want to step out against me. I told them. I seen that Grand Potente, Masonic nut, as a, listen, part of the wall in his bedroom. I pointed the motherfucker out. I said, you don't see the motherfucker right there? That shit fucks the motherfucker up when you got an eye to be able to see some shit like that, just like on the Beaver Washington thing. How long that Beaver Washington thing was put up? For a while, wasn't it? Ain't none of them niggas seen them Masonic figures in as part of the wall over her left hand shoulder. As you can see real good without scrunching eyes, too. You ain't even got, it ain't abstract, it ain't art deco, it's nothing. You can see that shit clear as a motherfucking floor. And I don't see how nobody saw them people as part of the wall. Right between, right over Beaver Washington's shoulder. Look at it on YouTube. It's right there to this day. You see them crackers smirking. But they say it's too late, hey, baby. So catch your statement now. Little stupid ass, that ain't going to get him out. What's wrong? And that's what it was going down. You can tell by the expressions on their face. That's very much alive. Why? Because we can be. We could be anything we wish to be in the home. I don't know why y'all didn't think this is open today. Shit. So if you could be anything you wish to be in the hall, I often say, well, I'm a spider. Your job is to enter my net without me knowing what do you become. And I then ask everybody and see what to say. Many people have given many different answers, but there's only one right answer right to this day, and that's you become a part of the web itself. See?
Yeah, that makes sense.
See? Now, notice here, you out on the internet net now. Ain't it? Internet now, internet. Child's gonna say internet. Internet right now.
Internet.
Right now, I'm internet. Internet. What? Who? Everybody talk that to me. It's only to me. I'll bump it out. See? Nobody really know what the hell I said, but. Internet going down. It's like,
so let me ask you a question.
What? Yeah, that's
right. Okay, so with the children, with the children's world movement. All right, get the T-shirt. I have a place I can go to get that. Get the logos. Get volunteers. Now I need some kind of agenda.
Okay, everyone. I know you. I don't know if you know what the logo is. The logo's already been established. Now, let me explain what it is. It's a globe, right? And around the top part of the globe, it says, Save the Children. And around the bottom part of the globe, it says, World Movement. Okay, you got me? And then across the globe, and then underneath that, right? Okay, you got that going around the globe, right? Then underneath that, you take little children, different ethnicities, like with the little hands reaching up toward the globe, you know, all the way around the bottom of the shirt, you see. And on the back of the shirt, you write, our motto is, it's hard enough to be homeless in America as an adult. Imagine what it is to be homeless as a child. That's what you write on the back of the shirt. You follow me?
Okay.
That line right there, that line, let me tell you something. Woo-wee, that line right there. You hear me? It's hard enough to be homeless in America as an adult. Imagine what it is to be homeless as a child. And you say that and you walk up to the first person you see and with a cup and say, Save the Children World Movement. Would you like to donate? Then speak from the heart, honey. Guarantee you the money starts coming your way. In fact, everybody's about to get to do a little Save the Children group thing real soon here now because I'm going to place the order soon here now. All you niggas finna go out peddling.
So that's being in every state their LCIS member, they should have also do the same thing that I'm doing over here in Virginia.
But you gotta set up the office first, baby, because we don't set the office up and make it look nice, you know. You know, do a little smudge thing with the niggas coming in and go. You have to say it right there, but the niggas come in and smudge their asses. Yeah, I got to finish go back around here into society. I was out at the Matrix for a little while with my sister Donna. Donna, I'm on the back of the dog. Kitty, but you know I love you. That's my baby. Come here. You know, then my little sister Diamond, come on. You been gone for a little bit. How long you been locked up, child? How long you locked up? Huh? How long?
Too long.
How long was it, nigga?
Too long.
You can't even remember how many days it was? She's delirious. She said I'm fucked up good. You be all right, baby. You can remember how many days it was after a while. Have you get some of that mystery meat out the system? You know, she ain't even sit that out yet. She just come home. And that's what we call a mystery meat. You be eating them things you think is bologna sandwiches. There ain't no motherfucking bologna. You think that's it? Throw that shit up against the wall. Pop! That motherfucker stick there. They don't even slide down. You're like, this motherfucker is. Look at this shit. Yeah, mystery meat. That's right. That's what it is. Mystery meat. I ain't even sit out all of it yet. I didn't get up and eat. Stuck to the good. Cut me your ribs up in there, don't you? You can't shake it loose or nothing. Yeah, it's bad. One of my stomach hurts. Part of my hernia thing was the mystery meat doing me. The mystery meat was kicking the hernia, and the hernia was kicking back, and man, I was in trouble. You hear me? Shit, we got to get a little hotel for a week. We got for 2 days. I'm going to heal myself. Fuck it. It ain't hurt nearly as bad as that. I put a Band-Aid on a cut that needs to stitch it. I hope it don't pop next time. But yeah, it ain't hurt me as much as it did. And good old Sarah Fowler will be helping. I hope she do. Maybe she was somewhere down there we could touch her hard. She gonna act a fool and bust the bands on another one. Bust the windows on another band. Damn, what the hell was wrong with her? That's some stupid shit. Stupid. I mean, how stupid can you be? This van belonged to those guys. You damn fool.
Yeah.
Hey, man, you, that dude.
All right, thank you.
You done lost your mind, huh? Mm-hmm. What's that, sir?
That's all I do is hurt people.
You love them. You finished with your question, honey?
I finished what?
Yeah. You finished with your question? You're not going to do you want to ask anymore?
Well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put something together when you run it past you again.
I
do have a question. Is the logo already made?
Yeah, the logo is still made. Get in touch with Times Webster. Get in touch with Times Webster. Tell that nigga I say send you a copy of the logo ASAP. And the website's up and everything. The website's up. www.SaveTheChildrenWorldMovement.com. I don't know, .org or one of them, you know.
Yeah, that's all right, I'm here. Webster.
He was in charge of that. Huh?
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, we did speak briefly about it. Gotcha.
Yeah, who was developing me behind, huh?
Terrence, this me.
God, what's up, nigga?
What's that?
He tried to tap dance in your living room tonight.
I know that.
What's up, bro? Shout it out.
I'm a tap dance in your living room, huh? Shout it out.
I know. What'd you say? Tap, tap, tap.
Yeah, that's right. I'm a tap dance in your living room tonight. You don't know. Hey, listen, come on now. Tell her. I know you on here to tell the sister what she needs to know, ain't you?
Yeah, we did.
Absolutely.
Speak about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Berlin, love one. Now shut up. It's your turn to talk, T-Tot. You know you're an elder, though, so I didn't know that, did you? T-Tot, you're an elder, though, so I see you elder now. What? Stock, you mean you're elders, huh?
Absolutely.
Go ahead and speak your piece then, fool. Why does it? You don't play with me. Just talk to me. Just act like you're something hot in your mouth. You don't know what to say. Talk.
I'm Annette. You know, like
yeah,
I said,
yeah.
The domain, the website is already established. It just needs to be filled in. The content, you know what I mean? The website needs to be filled in. You can either use that website or you can transfer it to another place to host it. You know what I mean? That which possibly would be a little bit easier for you to build the website
or ask Brandon
to help you with it.
One second. No, here's what I want you to do. You're going to complete it.
All right.
I told you how that website done. Look at me. I don't want that. That sister ain't doing nothing. Times, that website you told me was finished.
Well,
am I correct?
Exactly. Nah, it's not completely finished. No, it's not.
Well, here's what time it is. Guess what? What's the day? What day is this?
Today is February the 19th. Full moon, super moon.
Okay, here's super moon. You're going to be super computer man. There's going to be times you get on there and you ain't coming up no more than Friday night. What I mean by that, you're going to work solid from today till then to get that website up and running. It better look good, too. I'm telling you, want to know why? Because I'm going to be looking.
Yeah, I know.
I'm being hard. I told you I was going to tap dance in your living room tonight. Didn't I tell you I was going to tap dance? Ahead of time, I told you I was going to tap dance. And you better be at the computer monitor. I don't care if you got 211 or old English neck. I don't care. You can get it done.
I don't drink 211s no more, man.
Huh?
I don't drink 211s no more. I got
What you drink? Wild Irish Gold? You know, right?
Nah.
Keep black you.
Nah,
right now. Drink water, nigga. Drink some water. Drink water. That's what you drink. Drink water. That's all.
Yeah.
That's right. But it's all right to drink some Reeb. That's beer spelled backwards. You know, but, my auntie used to call it that. Just keep the kids from knowing what we're talking about. You give me a read about the refrigerator. What the fuck is a read, R-E-E-D, right? Read. Give me a read about the refrigerator. You feel me? Come on, let's stop it here, man. Let's get this bread. Come on, get the list. Hey, hello. We got a whole crew on my way. Who is that? Who is that? Hey, look here. I'll be back.
Fresh out.
It wasn't
green.
Hey, yo, look here. Hey, I'm going to, what I got to do, right, is I got, the brother's driving me and giving me the opportunity to be able to speak in an environment where, you know, at least I don't have so many people around me. It causes a very hard situation for me to deal with. I want you to know that each time I'm giving these conference calls, it's never an easy situation, number one, to be able to maintain a certain amount of, I don't know how to explain it, just leveled, peaceful, less chaotic environment, you know what I mean, so that I can answer everybody's questions. That I intend to change. I'm going to find somewhere where I can get, you know, and do this way up on somebody's hill somewhere where nobody's around me.
And we can talk for hours, you know,
as much as we want. But I'm still down in the thick of it. I'm in the ghetto, yeah. You see?
The world is a ghetto.
Yeah. Y'all know what time it is. That's right. All day is what we like to play. Yeah.
It's so nice to hear from you. Hear your voice.
What day?
It's so nice to hear your voice.
It's so nice to hear your voice. Oh, I love to hear you say it, girl. You just keep on telling me. But the more you tell me, the more I'm going to want to talk. Yeah, man, every time you come and tell me something so beautiful. It's nice to hear my one, but let me tell you something. You'll hear me talking all day, too. All day, all night, too. I won't never shut up. Just for you, honey. Yeah. Just for you. Everybody talk about everything under the stars and underneath the sun, too. Sure. Anything you want. Anybody got any questions? Come on, let's talk about it.
So, yeah, it's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while, but it's been a wild thing, you know. Wild thing. DJ Khalil, what his name was? I like that song. Hey, that's the Santana. That's almost like Stacey playing the guitar. Right? Santana, what the fuck is that? Well, wow, dang. What name that song was? I got to go over to yes, honey.
This Raj, I have a question.
Hey, no, wait, look. Go right ahead. Ask me. What?
Let's say, like this, when a person Taz, how's the burial ceremony should be? I thought I heard Pop saying that, don't let the body be defiled or stink. And so,
yo, let me say something. Let me say something. Hold on. Let's back it up. But it's very hard to hear your question and it's in a clarity with a clarity. I think I'm gonna have to hear this one with a clarity. If you will, please say your question clear into the phone and speak clearly, because it was cryptic almost on my end.
Okay, I want to apologize. I was over at work, but the question I had was. I thought I heard Pop say never let the body be defiled, like when a person passes. And so should it be cremated or just a regular burial?
Oh, without question, do not cremate your people. That is in itself is one of the worst atrocities anyone could ever perform. Why? Because
you
never know that after 72 hours, for 72 hours after a person dies, they can still feel that shit. So you're burning their people alive. That shit is crazy. You're going to take it, and then think about it, you're going to take their asses. Now, what the hell in mind? Think of anything with the word asses on it. Let me tell you something, you better raise the eyebrow. You know, it's going to rip away, because ass on command, don't fool yourself, it's the devil's allies. So, baby, you know what I'm saying? So, if you want to know, baby, bro, you have to bury your people like mummy. That's the right way. Then you wrap the body up. Use certain oils like frankincense and myrrh. You understand what I'm saying? Put the scent so that when the body goes into a state of decomposure, you see what I'm saying? You won't smell that scent. And all that shit they're using, the motherfucker undertakers that they use, that they think of bombing fluid and all that. Okay, yeah, bomb the motherfucker a little bit, but don't be so fucking rich with that you forget to put some spiritual shit up in there too. You know, it's like you gotta start to buy some oil. You got certain oils that are commercial, and then you got other oils that are talismans, meaning meant to be used, like muscovadema, you know, frankincense, like Egyptian Kush. You know, there are several body oils that do certain things in the home and do certain things with the smell as it surrounds the body. You see what I'm saying? But then you got, then you got Gucci, and then you got Blue Nile, or what is that? And they got a whole bunch of commercial shit that don't mean nothing. So the commercial shit, in terms of the burial, you see, would be burn their asses, head up and get done, so we get this motherfucker out of here and burn some more. You see, burn some more. Fuck that. Burn what? What you want to burn me? Burn my grandmama for? That's your mind? Why? Because white folks taught you that. And you listened to it to the point that you thought it was authentically so. Burn them up in termination is what you're doing. Y'all no reward in many of y'all. Damn fools. The hell wrong with you? You was your own motherfucker burning you up and you can't do nothing about it? But lay there and watch that shit? You think about it. It's not right.
The cells are still connected.
Huh?
Exactly. Because the cells be like the still connected. It still have the spiritual aspect of it.
Exactly. See, because you got to understand our crabs come at certain times to pick those etheric beings who are past the high life, to pick them up. If you look in the sky, you'll see when they release those umbilical cords. Those crafts release umbilical cords, like the one you see over Baba's head, like in that picture where you see Baba with his hand up like that, and you see the sham over the top right there. If you look, damn it, you'll see that there's an umbilical cord coming down to his hand. And let me tell you, them pictures come alive, Negroes, what you don't know. All you got to do is call on Baba. You see the sham lights come on. And then you see Baba come down that umbilical cord. You see it even look fat. You know how when a snake put a rat in his mouth or a mouse in his mouth and swallowed, you know how his stomach gets fat and, you know, all the way down? Same thing. Until it come right down into the pitcher. Boom, and then the pitcher come alive. Yeah, that's the same way bodies of all family members and living beings on this planet who, when they pass, you know, high life, they're dead now, right? See, they sat there in the grave, and then check it out, then we come pick their asses up. And if you look into the sky on certain days, you'll see the umbilical cords of the crabs that are assigned to doing this. So the order what you do, damn it, when you die, just lay your ass there and reflect on everything that you just got through, going through, meaning your life. You have memory of it all, but you'll be in such triple darkness. And keep your mind, don't nothing come back to the etheric realm that is not divine love. The only thing that will stop you from getting back to what you call heaven or us is fear.
Right.
So let me say something. You better be worried about. Y'all better worry about the second death, not the first one. The first right. death, you got action to, you know, eternal life still, right? The second death, you ain't got action in shit. Lights out. You ain't coming back. You fucked up. That's it. You gone.
Hey, you hear me? They don't want life. They want to die.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say. Listen. Life. Well, I'm telling you all, you're going to remember. You'll remember here today, child. Whoever you are, you'll remember it. See, you want to know why? Because memory of this is going to embed itself into your subconscious mind. And the minute you hit, you die and go to your grave, you'll be hearing the words I say right here now.
Nah, I ain't dying. The rest of y'all will die. I'm not dying. I'm
no, but you
that.
Miss when you miss right there, you go. Right? You like me. Fuck a diet. I'm going to live it to the fullest. Fuck Jenny Craig.
There is no tomorrow. Well, it's only now.
Yeah, when you say there is no tomorrow, you're absolutely right. There is only now. And right now so dictates that in this information, check this out, you'll find what you need to how to govern yourself if and when the day comes that you pass the higher life. That before, then listen, the hereafter. I want to make it to the hereafter. No one ever said the hereafter what? And Joel Ballhead, where you been?
The hereafter what?
That's what everybody should have been asking. The hereafter what? What? And then keep in mind, that term is in reference to what they call heaven. You see? And you say, which will be what? Also equivalent to the hereafter. Well, the here, meaning this planet, will become what you call our haven. And when you say after, meaning after the renewal of its soul takes place, it's going to take each and every one of us to bring in a new heaven and a new earth.